person, if all of our getting, get an understanding. And so communication is one of the most important things in marriage, and patience.
Is that what you did, Mama? That's how you been married 60?
62 years.
All right, praise the Lord.
I'm working on it.
Communication, patience.
Anybody else?
Next, we can just trickle down.
Go Linda Holmes, she next.
Oh, wait.
How long?
Grandma next.
It's very serious. Always to keep God in your relationship.
All right.
And really trust one another. Mm-hmm. Right? Learn to trust one another.
All right.
What, am I supposed to respond back?
No,
you just okay, yeah, okay.
Grandma.
I just want to say, always, through the good, the bad, we know God works all through Him. So, therefore, always keep that door open for communication.
All right.
Yes. No matter what, talk it out.
Ooh.
Communication is the number one thing.
All right.
We don't want to make me cry.
I got chill bumps.
Because it's real.
Right. She gave me, that's confirmation. That's confirmation. Anybody else?
Okay.
Sister Home, you was, how many years? She's so shy. She's so cute. You don't have to be, we don't have to put you on the spot.
Because you really was patient, Sister Home.
All right. Yeah, she was.
Because we done seen them come in the church in front of the bishop and say, oh.
No, they were.
Legs. I'm seeing Mama tying their legs together.
Not to my brother.
She didn't. She probably didn't say nothing, but you saw her face. Not on my watch. Anybody else?
I'll say, everybody said communication, but listening. Listening is part of communication.
Yes.
It's a very important
yes.
part. Yes. And I've spent a lot of time with the two of you.
Yes.
And I always tell people, I didn't put this on her wedding website about Lukey and her, but Luke was always very protective of Casey because mm-hmm. they always went to school together pretty much their whole life. Mm-hmm. And so if anybody tried to talk to her, he'd be like, hold on a minute. And so when Eugene came around, he was like, but Casey likes to talk. So mm-hmm. she always said, Eugene, he said, Eugene, you don't have to take that. You tell me. Be quiet, Casey. Don't let her talk to you like that, man. So.
Yes,
so
I'm worthless.
Yes. See, Grandma, it's only a few little bumps.
I want to say something.
Wait, we're going through the season first.
Right. I just watched it. Okay, go ahead.
Okay. She can say something. She can say something.
I got an attitude.
Okay. Bossy women up
there.
Right.
Well, I just like to say, I agree with everything uh-huh. you hear about communication and listening, mm-hmm. and you gotta have that trust.
Yep, that's
that trust.
Y'all saying it?
You gotta have that love.
Yeah.
You can't just withhold yourself because you're angry with him. Mm-hmm. Hold back. And he shouldn't do that either. Mm-hmm. But if you like to love and kindness,
mm-hmm. how about that?
You know, if he wants something, give him
something. What?
You can't hold back. That's the Bible.
Uh-huh.
hold yourself accountable.
Amen.
I'm working that too.
But that's what helped mine. No matter what I went through, I went through some changes. A marriage is not easy. It's not easy at all. Uh-huh. You have my spats, Cassidy, first part of your years, you're going to have them big time.
Never
go to bed mad at
you. That's it.
Always keep your marriage within your house. Whatever goes.
Comment. That's
first
it.
You go to God and then you talk to each other.
That's it.
But never go to bed angry.
That's it.
Always work it out. Yeah. And you know you got, so you good.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Anybody? I want to say something after you.
You can be last.
I'm sure I couldn't see. In my experience, all of that is true, but I think one other important thing, even though when you're listening and communicating all that, you need to believe what they say.
Uh-huh.
Don't try to interpret it, put your own spin on it.
That's
what they say is what they say, and I think they mean it that way.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
I like
their
that.
Truth.
All right.
And that's the other thing.
I know.
Hold this one. All right, I want to say something. Let me record this while I'm talking. Because I got every line. All right. Hold this up. I wanted to say something.
You want me to record you?
Not
to
say fair.
Don't cry.
Oh,
you get to speak before.
Go ahead.
The 1 and 2 year people.
Okay, go ahead.
No, Bean, go ahead.
All right. I was going to say to everybody, everyone was saying was confirmation. When you're going through stuff, keep in mind, when you go and take your business to someone else, see, you love him, but when you tell somebody what they done, then they got a different spin on it. Keep your stuff in your home. And if you want to put a scripture on it, the Bible says a brawling woman, when you get upset, what do you say? A brawling woman is like a wide house. You go to the wide. So in other words, you go to one side of the house, he go to the other side. Uh-huh. You can communicate. I like what she said. Don't never, ever go to bed mad. Don't go upset. But when you get on the phone, let me tell you what he did. Especially to another family member. Yeah. So, you know, work your stuff out. I think the only time someone should share something outside to another family member is when your life is in danger. And you ain't got to worry about that with Eugene coming there. Right. You know, he's just a beautiful, beautiful spirit person. Yeah. I loved him from this moment I met him.
Mm-hmm.
Just
to
swear. Yeah, you did it. So mannerable and just respectful, you know, and I like that. Casey is a good person too. Years ago, I've been engaged 4 times, and I remember being engaged.
Oh,
y'all remember? to her cousin. And I remember there's not a rule book to how we're supposed to handle marriage when you're new. So I remember I was 19, and all I knew was like to go by what I saw. So my mom sometimes would fuss at my dad, so I thought that's what I was supposed to do. And you get ready to go out of town, and I'd be like, where you going? And when you gonna be back? And he going on a family trip. He's like, oh, well, I'll bring you a gift back. And I said, well, in that case. So, I mean, I was always nitpicking and nagging and boom, boom, boom.
Don't do
but
it.
But a relationship is compromising. It's compromising. Everything ain't gonna be your way. And you really do have to compromise so and hear each other. And so instead of always yelling and bickering, because that's gonna happen, you will have, mama always say teeth and tongue will fall out. But then you're going to have those arguments.
Yeah.
But then never, ever go to bed upset, mad. Mm-hmm. Yep, work
that's
it out.
The word. That's the word.
Mm-hmm. And you got, I mean, as soon as she said it, she confirmed it. Mm-hmm. She confirmed it because, yeah. And that's a fact.
Okay. I don't even know where to start. Okay, first I want to thank you. Don't cry, cause I'm gonna cry.
Okay.
But I don't know how to. Okay. We're sisters.
Mm-hmm.
We have a very deep, unbreakable bond.
Mm-hmm.
Period. I'm happy that you're about to be a wife. We can do wife things together. We can travel as a family. We already do stuff as a family, but now I could be husbands and wives. You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Been there for you since day one.
What you say?
She not babysitting.
Amen.
You need to repent. You need to repent.
Well, I'll take your kids
with you. Because you know you're going to babysit.
I'll babysit.
And grandma. And you need to repent, mom.
Kayla.
You know you're going to babysit.
Right.
Just lock it down. Don't worry about it.
Okay, Casey.
Keep on going.
I do want to say that I love the woman that you have become, you know, and Eugene, but you know, I love Eugene to death. Literally, I do anything for him just like I do anything for you. I'm always be there for him, for you going through anything. You know, you can do me. Everything the lady said is true. I'm 2 years in the marriage, I'm saying the game. And Denise was right, it's hard. But when you put God first, it's a turnaround.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Trust me.
Uh-huh.
On both ends. Not just you, not just him.
What's wrong?
Both of y'all.
Mm-hmm.
It
right.
has to be both. Yeah. But anywho.
What's hard?
So what's hard?
Huh?
What's hard?
Oh, marriage is hard. It's a job.
She being nasty.
Yeah.
Go.
We're not going with you, girl. You can call me on the phone. We can talk about that as well. But yeah,
Delphi.
I get it from our mom, so I'm back out of you. So yeah, I love you, and I'm proud of you.
Mm-hmm.
I'm proud of both of y'all. I wish she was here to hear this, but I'm proud of both of y'all. Y'all were there for me. For us, before we had children, there for us more.
Yes.
Even now that we didn't have y'all drive to East Lansing, Illinois, just whatever.
Mm-hmm.
It's only going to get better and stronger. And like I said, I'm there for you or whatever. And in the aspect of becoming a wife, my advice, I ain't going to say much because clearly the unseasoned people don't know much. I want to encourage you to always be his support.
Mm-hmm.
Always ride. Ride for him, you know what I'm saying?
Ride for him.
Yeah.
Like
it's you and him against the world.
Mm-hmm.
Just
you know we owe him to ride for him.
Be his backbone, his spine. His
and
Paul.
No, she talking about ride
but
or die.
But I'm trying to sound appropriate in front of everybody. And I love you, that's my story.
I'm
about to see
you
thinking.
All right.
Aww.
Aww.
So
oh, VJ.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
I can't see her.
Casey.
Yes.
My little nurse.
I'm going to get emotional.
Don't cry.
I'll try not to. But Casey is my little nurse. She's very, very, very dear to my heart. I love all three of them. All three of my goddaughters.
Mm.
And I really appreciate you because you's just a little tiny top. And I used to, she was so sweet. And just, I never had any issues with Casey, any problems with her being obedient or being, or talking back or anything like that. She's always been very respectable and very sweet and loving. And I remember when she was about, she was in school, maybe seventh grade, mm-hmm. and I was staying with them. And I've stayed with them several times when I got out of the hospital. And she was always there. Inventory, you need anything? You want me to do this? You know, just there, very helpful. Mm-hmm. And so, and I don't know what your major is, but I said, she would make a perfect nurse. Mm-hmm. She's just, you know, she's there. She feels, it's like she feels your pain, you know? Mm-hmm. And she was very comforting to me as, you know, 13, 14 years old. But I love Casey, and I wish nothing but the best for her. And she and Eugene are going to make a wonderful couple.
Yes.
You can tell, you know, even before, well, they're not married yet, that they were going to be, they're going to be a wonderful husband and wife because they respect each other, mm-hmm. and they talk. They're just connected. You know, when you get married, it seems like you start looking like an individual. Now it seems like they're like brothers and sisters because of that connection. And I love Eugene. I love them both so much. And always, I heard several who want to speak, always keep God first in your relationship. Because without Him, you can do nothing. But if you put God first, you can accomplish anything you want to accomplish.
You don't make me cry.
And one other thing that I wanted to say, you know, after you get to become a senior citizen a lot of times, I'm so happy for you, and I wish you many, 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 many years together.
That was beautiful. Nick wants to say something. Nick?
No, I was just going to say, I remember when Casey, I think you had just graduated or you were still in high school, mm-hmm. and you and Eugene broke up.
Oh.
Well, but before that, you had said you were telling Delphine that you were going to marry him.
Oh, this was in high school. In high school. Okay. He was in high school.
Mm-hmm. No, you're not going to marry him. You're going to go your separate ways. You're going to go to school. He's going to go to school.
Yes.
You're going to remember.
No. We were at TC's, cousin TC's something. Her shop.
Yes.
I remember this like
it was. Right, and she did. I did. What I said, because she was so young, I was like, you ain't gonna marry, it's good, you have to experience him. So to say you're gonna marry him, she said, I know that we're gonna be married. Yeah. And I was like, I said, you could.
I was honestly confident in middle school and we was in band together. You know,
it was
people gotta go through stuff.
Right.
Yeah. And I mean, I won't say he went through more than what I went through, but like,
so
you know,
proved,
we had to grow. I sure did. Did we make a bet?
$100? $100.
Don't be reminding her of that. You got it right there.
I knew money.
Wait. You know what? She done ate me out of house and home. Anytime we go somewhere, and if it, I just want shrimp. Steak and shrimp. I'm like, hey, she's 7 years old, steak and shrimp.
While during college, she would send a text. Family, about that time. Like,
I need to care about
that. She needs some what?
Care packets. Luke, I got one that case.
He learned. He picked up.
Oh yeah, he learned.
I didn't know it was so costly to send kids stuff. I'm getting the big old huge box of can. You go to try to mail that. I said next time I'm driving it up there. God was like, what? What was it? Some crazy amount, $100 a mail? I said we driving it.
Yeah, it was a lot of stuff.
Heck yeah.
She had canned food.
Yeah, you had enough stuff for a long time. Yeah.
Anybody else?
Can I say one more thing?
Huh? I know.
Oh, just go ahead.
Because Yeah, really. Danielle, how long has you been married? How long now? You've been married. Are you serious? She been married 11 years.
Wow.
11? Man. Yeah. Girl. That's wisdom over there. Man, I didn't know it was that long.
Wow. I mean, everybody already said it, but it's definitely the trust. Because trust me, I'm married to a musician.
Uh-huh.
The women come at him too that way.
Yep.
Definitely do.
Oh, yeah.
Trust, patience. And everything.
Yep.
Patience.
All right.
Yeah, as long as y'all got each other back.
That's it. All right.
Can I say one more thing?
Hold on, Cassidy.
Let him go. All right.
You want to say anything? No, go ahead. I'm going to watch you
all night.
Yes, she will. Delphine Jr.
Truly, definitely always keep God first in absolutely everything you do. Always communicate. Never go to bed angry. Even though sometimes you're hard to do that because the next day it just gets worse. Because you're looking at each other like, you still ain't got nothing to say? Like, it's still going to get worse. Each day you let it go.
Yeah.
And respect each other's growth.
That's it.
You're going to grow as individuals.
Yes.
You're going to grow as couples. You know, you're going to be different at 30. Mm-hmm. You guys grow together and make sure you don't grow apart.
That's it.
Communication is such the bridge to growing together and not apart. Mm-hmm. So I just want to say that. And then I also want to say that Casey is such a remarkable young lady. She has grown in such a way that has blew me off the water in so many ways, especially when she transferred up to Michigan State. The person that she became is just that she bloomed into.
Aww.
Being Yogi being my son, my firstborn son, and extremely close to my son for many, many, many years, watching him go through many transitions. It was so hard to let go, but it was easy for me to let go because of the woman that he chose.
Aww.
And when a mom feels that his son has transitioned and he's going to someone, I don't worry about Yogi. Even though he don't call me, normally I'd be like, you ain't call your mom, it's been the weekend. I know that he is in good hands, and I know if something ain't right, Casey called. So I don't even have to worry about that. I am so blessed to be able to spotfully call her my daughter-in-law. And I just love you, Casey. And that's
it. Oh, that's so sweet.
I don't even know if I can say what I'm about to say.
That was so sweet. Okay, hold on, I got some tissues. That was sweet. That was so beautiful.
Yeah, it was.
Okay.
Okay, I'm going to just say this. And I probably shouldn't say it, but I'm going to say it.
Wait, tell me in my ear before you.
No. I'm going to say it. You know, I forgot to say that Casey is the best aunt the world to my kids. They got awesome, great aunts, but Casey is the best aunt. Me and Kevin will claim it forever. Mm-hmm. But one thing I want to say is, you know, I love my job. Mm-hmm. Absolutely, and I love it. Mm-hmm. But I know you want to wait to have children.
Wait a minute.
But if you don't want to wait, I will stop working again.
Kevin.
And I'll take care of them. Take care of her kids.
I need to graduate.
Let me just let us buy this house first, and then it'll be enough time. And if you want to have them, don't worry about a babysitter. Don't worry about none of that.
Okay.
When I say I got you, I got you.
You got
wait. So if you don't want to wait,
you are that. Okay.
This is the closest I'll ever come to being a mom.
Right there. But if you don't want to wait, girl, just let me know.
Let me know.
So I can prepare.
Half on.
I was going to look. Grandma.
Go ahead,
Grandma.
Go ahead and live your lives. I got a baby.
I know that's right.
Maybe I just want to stop working.
Mama won't talk again. See, Mama is senior, so she thinks of things in pieces. And so we may be here for another 3 hours. No, I'm joking. Go ahead,
I just
want to
say something about Eugene. Everybody says, but he is everything they said.
And more.
I picked up one thing about him. He's so sweet. He is so, so sweet. When he come in the house, if I'm in the kitchen, he'll give me a hug. But he's making it upstairs. Mm-hmm. He's going to granddad's room. He take up a lot. Most time, you don't, well, my husband is, how do you say it?
He has dementia.
And going through a lot right now. Mm-hmm. But Eugene take up so much time with him. When he come in the house, he gonna make it up there. Hey, granddad, and talk to him like he's just a young person.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
But he knows that some things he remembers. Money, he's up on. You can't, when it comes to money, you can't cross it.
Right.
In his army, his job stuff, he's got that down pat. Mm-hmm. And he may forget everything else.
He'll forget me.
Since she said that first, I'm going to say this now. He said, you ain't got no sense.
I agree with everything. And the one scripture, the portion of it, love covers.
Mm-hmm.
And yeah, with everything everyone has said, keep the love of God.
Mm-hmm.
And it covers, and it, as a matter of fact, I believe the scripture said love never fails.
It never fails. I like her voice.
I know. It's so
she's so sweet. Yeah, your voice, such a sweet one.
I listen to her all day.
I know.
Love you too.
You got some moves?
I know.
Well, she didn't
have to be friends. I'm not going to tell the story about her apartment.
No, about what? I am going to tell her. Which one? Which one?
Which one?
I do. She just reminded me. She said, real quick. She said, I thought Aunt Delphine was going to tell the story about the apartment. I was kind of used to Cassie. No, it's okay. So I tell Cassie, I was trying to clean, when I was standing in Ipsy, I was trying to clean my closet. So I said, you know what, Casey and Eugene volunteered to do it. I said, okay, so I was going out, it was like a Saturday night. So I said, they young, so I know they're going to be trying to get busy in the house. So I set my camera and I had it in the hallway facing the closet. So I had it set. I knew it was going to run for about 3 hours. So I get back. I said, oh, yeah, I know I'm going to see something juicy on there. So I'm up here looking at the camera. They cleaning, and then Eugene get to playing with her, like just tickling her stuff. And she's talking about, Eugene, we got to get busy. We got to finish this closet. Then he get to the closet. I was like, this is the most boring thing. They worked the whole time. You can definitely trust them. I was one of those. I know if it was this one. I said, where'd she go? The camera playing. Closet wouldn't be done. She did.
Okay. I don't really need to say much to Casey because, you know, she's been with me. She came home about a week ago, so we've been doing a lot of talking, you know, because I tell her, with men, especially Christian men, you do have to be patient because, they're first of all, their job is to please God, to make sure they're an honorable soldier of the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Let me put it like that. So sometimes you feel like we're not getting enough time.
always doing this, and then it's their job because they have to provide for the family. And she knows this because her dad has been going out of town for the past 2 months. Every Saturday, Sunday, he's somewhere else for his job. And I'm like, not everything on me to try to do. And I'm like, I don't be taking no trash out. And so I'm looking at one of them, somebody gonna take the trash out? We're gonna wash the dishes. Or we'll let them all sit to a certain time and then we'll go. So just us being in the house these past 2 months on the weekend by ourselves, I've learned. I told Casey the other day, I'm one of y'all. Oh, I miss your dad.
That was me.
Aww. When I found out so much I had to do with the dad, literally, I felt this, like, it wasn't sad, but I felt like, man, if he was here, I would just give him a good hug and tell him how much I
miss him. That's it.
So, and sometimes at night, me, I'm not going to answer this, but like, sometimes I'll wake up in the middle of the night and I just look at him. Casey. And it be kind of dark, but I keep my teeth on and I just look at him and I take that bald head and just rub it.
That sound nasty. You
know, so, but it's just because you learn to appreciate. But then when...
What that feel like? Greasy?
No. When you have a good mate that is a good provider, communicator, take care of his home, and the wife can pretty much do what she wants, you know, as long as it's...
Yeah, we know.
And he keeps her happy. I like to agree with what I heard about the women. So everybody know when a husband and wife, they're married, they're not going to just be separated all the time. The Bible speaks of coming together.
Amen. Amen, sister.
When you come together, that makes that woman submissive.
Mm-hmm. Submissive. Yep. We don't use that word in this house. No, I'm joking. I'm joking.
But listen to what I'm saying. The Bible says that a man should love his wife as Christ loved the church, that he gave himself. Yes. I ain't expecting Don to run out in front of a semi the block for me.
Right. You
know, I do.
But his love for me
should
be there like that.
Yeah. Yeah.
So when a man love a woman like that,
Smack Diddy.
Diddy doll.
Those are old sayings.
I'm going to do everything I can to make sure that man stays happy.
All right.
That's why we go and beautify the home. Mm-hmm. When the kids come in, they all happy and clean.
Every time you come home, the bathroom is different.
She got her back showing.
So I got to tell my girls, all of them, be submissive to your man.
Yeah.
Before I run Dick, Tom, and Harry at dinner and make sure they ain't hot, whatever, I'm going to make sure my man don't need nothing.
Yes, Mom.
Better put a ring on
him. Keep in mind to be submissive to your man.
Mm-hmm.
And he'll be.
She going to have to work on this.
A wise woman once told me, Mother Eliza Holmes, she told me one day, I had put on some jeans. They wasn't like Chantel's. They were deep.
What's Chantel?
And I was over to Mom's, and I loved to talk to her because she had a lot of wisdom. Uh-huh. So we was in there talking, and I noticed she kept looking at me. And she said, if your husband tell you to take them off, you take them off. And me thinking, okay, she's a very spiritual woman. I thought she meant, you know, take these pants off that pertaining to a man and put a dress on, right? That wasn't what she meant. Because I was like, Grandma, these are my pants. These belong to me. And she was like, I ain't talking about that. And then it dawned on me. She was saying that if your husband wants
Nick,
you,
test it. Don't test it.
Be submissive. Right. So just be submissive to Eugene.
She's gonna do it.
Talking about Casey right
now. Can I say one thing?
Yeah. Surprise him.
Uh huh.
Surprise me. You don't have vacation.
Right.
Please.
Yes.
I'll get you outside the garage.
What? Right. She
rides us. Pull a surprise on.
Casey, I can't wait till this over so we can talk.
Because I see what she said.
Yes,
Wait. But you know what? But you know what?
Listen.
But a lot of people do. A lot of people let their fire die. She is right. I was just reading an article not too long ago. It says, whatever you do over the years, don't stop touching each other. Cuddling, hugging. That's because what happens is it gets worse and worse. You find yourself, you ain't looking at them no more. That little spark. Then you ain't touching. Then you sleeping apart. Then you, it ain't nothing there. Then your home is dead. So, yeah.
What am I supposed to do? You know what you're supposed to do?
I'm gonna tell you what you're supposed to do. That's what you're supposed to do. And I know. Y'all done. She gonna open up the gifts. Y'all is getting raw.
People a little hectic, so I'm apologize in advance if I don't get to see you one that day.
Oh, he don't have no shoes.
You know why he out here? I can smell it.
Uh-oh. What?
He boo-boo.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, shit.
Right. That's how they do. That's what they do.
Take him out on the pool deck.
That's Casey, baby.
I do the same thing, though. And look at her, glued on the phone. Oh, you done? Thank you.
But yes, and I appreciate all the words of wisdom. I will take them all. I'm just really gonna work on my patience and being submissive.
Because Eugene is perfect. Because, you know, he's like, I know Casey.
Right.
And I love that. Right. He's going to be patient with you.
I'm going to be patient with him, too. Okay.
Just listen. Listen is the key word.
Yeah, listen to communication. Be faithful and trustworthy and... Y'all, to be honest, not to toot my own horn, but I think we gonna be good.
Every 5 years, you go through changes.
Right. Our goal is to go on a vacation every year, whether it's a weekend trip.
That's right. Take time for yourself. Make it happen. I believe in traveling and getting out of Dodge.
And keep it hot.
After 40 years, you'll still be the same.
But, yeah.
40 years.
Good.
Grandma's been married
60.
Almost 70 years.
Wow.
I know.
Well, I'm on the trail behind me.
Yeah. I mean, we'll get there. Mm-hmm. It's a long time, but we'll get there. Yeah.